You are not alone. Christ says, I have come to speak to you in colloquial language as far as I am able, to reach people who have not yet found my letters and who, presently, see no reason to read them. In fact, my letters, explaining what I taught in Palestine and giving further explanation of the origins of creation, will give receptive people the means to overcome every difficulty encountered in existence. This may sound like a far-fetched claim, but it is nonetheless true. The letters give you information known to true masters who showed that they had control of atomic states of being by controlling the elements and creating food and objects from nothing. I also controlled the elements, healed and created necessities, and was only able to do so because I possessed the deep and secret knowledge I have shared with you in my letters. Do not compare my message to you with the messages from others. Everyone has their unique mission and purpose in life, and mine is exclusively to give you the exact means to lift yourselves out of your present turmoil of existence, nothing else. Therefore, my messages may be repetitive, but they are directed solely to inspiring and helping you to make a decision to follow Christ's way, my way, no matter how difficult you may find that way to be. You will persevere because along my way, you will find rewards which will prove to you that you are definitely on the right path. But you cannot put foot to my way unless you realize fully and completely that the entire universe is consciousness, awareness made visible through the interaction of electrical particles and magnetism. This is fully explained in letters 5 and 6, but reading alone will not make you a master. A true master understands that the origin of all creation is universal consciousness, and that it is the divine source of all love and intelligence. To be a true master, a person has to understand the way the universe has come into being, know intimately the true nature of universal consciousness, and has to so purify himself of the impulses of the ego that he is absolutely free of all ego impurities in his mind and emotions. When he reaches this state of inner cleanliness of thought, feeling, and action, never demanding of others but willing and eager to give to the utmost of all he possesses, because he knows perfectly well that he can have anything he needs, he will be a perfectly open channel of divine consciousness, which is the creative impulse within this dimension of visible creation. When he has achieved such a state of inner purity and cleanliness, he will live in a state of inner joy, peace, and unconditional love. He will understand the living world and the difficulties such living things encounter, and feel an immediate and spontaneous love and compassion for all. He will have transcended the world and its millions of self-interests, self-indulgences, experiences of despair, fear, revenge, hatred, slandering, gossip, rejection of others. All these worldly activities will go on around him, but he will not experience them himself. He will only feel boundless compassion and love for them. He will only long and yearn passionately to teach the world the truth of being. He will make every sacrifice with joy to help people understand the truth and live it in their every thought, word, deed. He will do this because it will be painful for him to know that as people stubbornly persist in their own way, thinking, feeling, reacting, in any way that their emotions prompt them to do, they are only creating more of the same misery which has driven them to seek a way out of it. When people eventually find their way out of the morass of their chaotic thinking and emotional reactions, they discover that this is the only true way to happiness, and they are exceedingly relieved and grateful that they have managed to surmount their habits of thought and feeling, which previously pulled them down into experiences, causing them pain and misery. Do not marvel or question that it is truly I, the Christ, speaking to you. I come to speak to you through the total emptiness of my recorder's mind and heart, and speak those things which are necessary for you to know to start to put behind you the sadnesses and despair of the past, and to give you the courage and incentive to start anew, daily meditating and drawing into your human consciousness the divine consciousness which brought you into being in the world. Above all, I want you to understand you are not alone in your struggle to live comfortably and happily. You are not alone in your battle to change your habits of thought and feeling. The more you call upon for divine consciousness, even if it is only a momentary connection you set up, you are drawing into your consciousness new life and moments of intelligence and love, which will inspire you to an even greater degree as you persevere and do not lose heart. As you call on me, you will make contact with my Christ consciousness and will eventually be aware of my response and instruction when you have questions to ask. Remember that it takes time to purify your thoughts and emotions and negative reactions to other people. Until you have got rid of your deep and darkest feelings of anger, vitriolic criticism, rejection, resentment, and frustration, you will not be able to hear my voice. Remember that to receive even my first whispers in the silence of your meditation or during a moment of inner quiet, you have to make changes in your consciousness. You have to become fully aware that love is the only way to freedom. And this takes patience and time. You are not alone. We who have moved into the highest echelons of spiritual realization and divine consciousness have only love for you, and our most urgent desire is for your escape from travail and your progression into light, wisdom, and unconditional love.